In this laboratory in Oxford, a glimmer of hope. Human trials have now begun here with a vaccine. Researchers are confident that it could take just months before they know if it would work. Manufacturing it on a large scale could take much longer.
Hopefully this will give us some good data, and then hopefully in a couple of months or maybe a year or so we'll be able to protect more people with this.
In Germany, the first day back at school, but nothing like these pupils could have imagined. A partial reopening for older pupils only carries many restrictions. Social distancing is tightly enforced between their designated desks, the usual hive of energy replaced by a more careful, serious mood. Despite having the fifth largest number of confirmed coronavirus cases in the world, Germany is slowly relaxing its lockdown. But a desire for things to return to normal, as well as fears over the economic impact of the pandemic, have come with a warning from the Chancellor Angela Merkel.
I will therefore tell you quite frankly that I fully support the decisions taken by the federal and state governments on Wednesday last week, but their implementation since then worries me. In part, it seems to me very brisk. Some of it seems to me to be quite brisk, if not to say too brisk.
For the European Union, the full extent of the damage the pandemic has caused the bloc won't be revealed for months. But it is preparing for a slump, the like of which has not been seen since World War II. The European Commission has suggested a $325 billion recovery fund for its forthcoming budget, as well as borrowing another $350 billion from capital markets for further spending.
I'm really optimistic, because even if it's difficult, even if of course there are different sensitivities in the European Council, it's not a surprise, I feel there is a very strong political will to work together and to succeed, to build compromises.
And the political strains are already evident. Wealthier countries such as France will remain under pressure to provide aid to the bloc's less well-off members as a test of solidarity. That could define the very future of the Union itself. Sonia Gallego, Al Jazeera.